So, ladies and gentlemen, have you heard about the passive leopard gecko before? If you have not, in this video, I'll be guiding you guys down what the passive leopard gecko morph is and share you guys all the information that I know. As always, I'll be breaking it down to four different categories. Number one is going to be the history and genetic traits, characteristic, and some example photos that are mixed with other lines. So, without further ado, let's get into it. So starting with the history, it was found in 2008 while Mr. Chamber was working with Raptor Project. For those who may not know what the Raptor is, it is the red-eyed, albino patternless Chamber orange. Now a long time ago, the way he knew this was going to be the new gene was when he saw the blue belly from his new hatchlings. For the first couple of years, he was test breeding, and around 2014, when he started getting better results, he sent out a couple of his geckos to numerous breeders in Asia and Europe regions to get more accurate information about his genetics. During all these years, he was still struggling how this three hatchling came out to be the blue belly, and around 2017, he finally figured it out by crossing Passeraptor to Snow Hypo, we now call that mix as a creamsicle. It took many years to find out the accurate genetic traits, but now we can finally say it's a polygenetic, which in other words, we call it lion breed. Now for the characteristic part, it's considered to be the color enhancer. It makes the color more vibrant, rich, and in the first generation. The reason why I pointed out the first generation is because in many cases, when you do lion breed with the best quality geckos, you do end up getting a better result every year. But for this one, it seems like it's working backward. It sounds like the quality actually gets worse as you do more line breeding for this line. So take a note of that if you're thinking about putting this line into your project, because this is one of the key informations I think we should all aware when we are working with the Pasture Leopard Gecko project. Also, I have found out that Pasture works really well with WY, so if you have tried it or doing it this year, let me know how it went. I really want to find out if that's true. As we all know, when it comes to the genetic part, we definitely need to know about their health. After many pairing, this genetic, it does sound like it is a safe genetic to work with, and I've also heard that females do lay more eggs if it carries the Pasture genetics. Now for the appearance, this gene shows a pie-like pattern on its head like a galaxy, which in other words we call it as a super snow eclipse. And it also shows a white leg, in other words white socks, and lighter marking on its head, when geckos are young especially. For reference, left picture is the Pasture Chamber albino, and the right picture is the regular Chamber albino. Now that I went over all the information, let's take a look at the example photos that Mr. Tramper shared on his website. By the way, I did add link this time under the description. If you want to check it out and read the full information, feel free to do that right now while you're watching this video. So when I went into his website, the first image that I found was the reverse stripe lavender with the pastel projects. So for lavender, when I always look at those lines, there's two different things that I always remember, and one is the yellow color, and the second one is going to be the purplish color with the yellow. On this picture, it's not really came out clearly for the purple one, but you can definitely see the yellow and some reverse stripe pattern there in the picture. The second picture that I found on his website was the giant tangerine mixed with the lavender pastel hat raptor. And third one is the Passeraptor. These two looks totally different, but this does show us that good example what the Passer actually do carries. When you see the picture on the left, this one has a patternless, but also you can find out that those pie pattern on its head right between those eyes. So that's one of the things that happens when you have a pastel project going on with other lines. And the other one that you see on the right is some bright orange marking on its head. So those are the two main characteristics that you do find when you're working with the pastel. And also you will be seeing those white legs on its front and the back. Usually those white legs, though, seems like it's going to disappear as they get older. But I do think that the patternless one does still have that, some of that white color legs. Now the next picture that I have here is the striped snow pastel raptor. You know, although pastel does bring that bright orange whitish pattern on its head, sometimes those colors could fade out depending on which gecko you're breeding with. And this example photo definitely shows those patterns, those bright patterns are starting to fade away as they get older. The next photo that I have here is going to be the Tangerine River Striped Passer Raptor. And this one is a little bit hard to tell when it comes to the pattern part, but it's just, I guess, based on his information, it still considers to be the reverse stripe pattern on its back. And also you do see that bright orange color on its head. Now for the last picture, this is going to be the super giant passer snake-eyed raptor, which is a super, super big size gecko. So overall, when I was doing research about this line, I only knew the blue-belly part because the picture went super, super viral when it was released in the public. But after I learned every little thing about the story and how it was created, Mr. Tremper has put so much work and time into the leopard gecko industry. Now I understand why so many people appreciate him in the leopard gecko world. I do still think there are so many opportunities to find more new lines in the future and can't wait what will be the next one. Now, do you guys think this is a cool morph? Would you guys be interested in working with this line? Comment below. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you guys in the next one.